I'm Jale, welcome to my channel. This is going to start the second part of the month, December's readings for the astrological signs. This is an Aries reading. So if you are Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising and or Venus signs, this reading could be for you. Or alternatively, you could be a cross watcher for an Aries. This message could also be for you too. This is going to run from around the 15th up until and including the 31st of December 2020. Remember, this is a general reading. Take what resonates and leave the rest. If you feel like some parts resonate, then just go with that. And if you feel like I'm saying them and it's you, then again, swap the roles accordingly. This is a general reading. Obviously, I would love for absolutely every single detail to resonate with everyone, because it would mean that's helpful, I'm assuming, but it's unrealistic. So let's see what we can do. As I say, this is just take it as some advice and guidance and use your own discernment. Okay, let's have a look, Aries. What is the theme, please, for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, please, from the 15th up to and including the 31st? Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. From the 15th to up to and including the 30th. Do you know? I feel pressure. I don't know why I want to say that. I feel like there's some pressure. I'm hearing illumination. We've got the sun here. Again, with the sun, could be some heat, something that's being kind of asked of you, maybe. But we've also got the fall. So there's a new cycle beginning. So there could be a bit of a relief after some pressure, possibly. But let's have a look. Let's take some other cards and see what else we can gain from this information. We're going to use the Oracle, the Chakra Wisdom Oracle cards. This is a new deck. Let's have a look. Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, please. Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, please. From the 15th up to and including the 31st. They're just saying use discernment. I think there's a decision that you're going to have to make here. Let's have a look. I'm going to be really honest with you. I'm hearing cut and run. So if you, let's say, for example, you're involved in a situation that's, the pressure's been building. Don't be afraid to do your own thing right now, because I'm going to be real honest with you. The energy from around the 20th onwards is that I feel it's pressurized. So if you're around a connection, let's say, for example, then their shadow element hasn't been merged. They've got addictions. They've got things going on. You need to focus on you. Be the balance. So if they're not in there integrating their shadow element, be you in your authenticity, because there's going to need to be, it's like a very strong energy here. So you need to do your own thing. That's a really strong message coming through, and I feel like it might be for most of the signs. But let's have a look. Aries, please, what is the theme for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, 15th up to and including the 31st of December 2020? What's the theme, spirit? Aura. So can you see here, we've got the sun, but we've got enlightenment. Let's just double check the deck's not, hang on. Yeah, this is the other way. So we've got some kind of illuminating situation with the sun and enlightenment. There's a big truth coming, okay? But with any truth, again, it could be that you're understanding that this person's not ready, you're not ready, there's a situation that's not quite ready. It's going to require faith, okay? So we've got faith on the bottom of the deck. Your guides are trying to help you with this. And this is not going to be to say, oh, well, it's over now and it's done and there's no hope. It could be divine protection, because this is not ready. Because I feel like there could be some addictions going on here with someone. Let's have a look. Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, please. Aries, from the 15th up to and including the 31st. What's the theme? Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Yeah, you need to build on this. This is something that you're going to need to focus on, or you don't have to do any of this, but it's an advisory, okay? If something's, I'm just hearing that they don't be allowing them to take from you. If someone's, again, in an addictive pattern of behavior, don't let that take away from your self-esteem. That's their issue that they have to resolve. You can still obviously extend a hand of friendship, but don't let it be at the expense of you. They're saying, again, we're going into Capricorn season, which is devil energy. So the shadow element is going to be brought up again with this solar eclipse on the 21st and the conjunction that we're going to be having. Again, with the yellow card here, this is talking about the solar plexus, which is about confidence and self, is about willpower and confidence. Now, the solar plexus chakra of the world, Uluru, is going to be of a particular heightened energy in Australia around the 21st. I feel everyone's getting upgrades in this. So it's like the illumination is going to bring an upgrade that people are going to want to focus on what they want to focus on. We've got the castle here. So it could be that you're going to look at more healthy energy around building up, you know, you've got a new cycle coming, basically. Let's have a look. Aries, please. 15th. Oha. Yeah. Someone, this ring landed on enlightenment. So again, we could be in a cycle here. The ring could be a cycle, but it could also be about commitment. Someone could know that actually you're them for them, but they're not quite ready. So they have to go off and finish it. Or let's have a look. The ring could be that there's an actual offering here. We've also got the mask around the castle. So there's a situation here that someone's not quite being honest about. So let's take a look at what that is involving there. Spirit, what can you tell us please about Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs? From the 15th up to and including, we've got lightning, sudden change, shocking news, surprise, epiphany, upheaval, transformation. And we've got Cupid's arrow. Have faith, love is coming, surprise, invitation or meeting and hesitation. So we've got two faith. So again, someone could realize their feelings and want to break into something. There could be proposals here. I'm going to just put that out there. Does that guarantee that you're going to have a proposal? No, please use discernment. Could be about 1% of you. We've got air. Work with the element of air to cut through the core of a situation and see the truth. We've got a lot of truth cards here. So although you guys are Aries, you could have strong air in your chart. They could have strong air in their chart. Again, use discernment here. We're going to use the Oracle of the Radiant Sun for some more information. For Aries, please. Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Aries. Aries, please. Achievement and fulfillment. Someone could be slowly coming around to the idea that they, again, they could have been putting something off. There could have been a cycle that was never ending with this ring. Again, a cycle of an ongoing dispute or, you know, reconciliation or something. But that's coming to an end. All right. There's some kind of an awareness here. But there's definitely someone coming to the realization of a fulfillment that maybe they know that at some point they have to give in to. Maybe they wanted to run from. Let's have a look. Aries, please. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Aries. What is happening for Aries? Okay. We've got Goddess. And we've also got a card here that's disappeared. Let's see what you're from. Again, you could have been waiting for this situation to come through. You could have been tentatively waiting on an offer. All right. Someone is coming to the realization that you are for them. They are for you. Feminine expressed through wisdom, nature, life force and sensuality. So someone is, I'm hearing, claiming you. That sounds a little bit intense. Maybe you're going to sit there and think, absolutely not. That's your divine right to say absolutely not. But for those of you that are waiting for this, then again, don't, because we've got martyr on the bottom of the deck, learn the transcendent nature of service to oneself or a cause. So don't do this at the expense of all other things. So again, make sure there's a balance in this situation. Let's see, what else do we want to pull here? I want to go with the Lenormand. I want to go with the Lenormand here. There's a Lenormand card in here for you guys that I'm going to, let's see, Aries, please. What is the theme? Why am I hearing Frederick? Okay, let's have a look. Why do I not have a camera right now? Why do I not have a camera right now to show what's just happened? Maybe you're going to also say the same thing when this news comes through, because you may say, oh my goodness, no one's ever going to know how this felt until I explain it, and even then it's not going to do it justice. You can't make this up. Okay, I'm going to just say this one thing now. If you don't want something to be spoiled, click off now. If you don't want a spoiler, you need to click off now. If you've got a feeling something is building up and you're like, yeah, but I kind of don't really want this to be acknowledged in this reading. Like, I want to be surprised. You need to click off now. I'm giving you the last warning, and then I'm going to just say what I need to say. I'm telling you the truth here. But someone, if you do not want to know what this is, click off, because this is going to be like, we've got the ring again, right? But get this, the ring landed on the mask and it next to expectation. So someone's been waiting for this, but someone's been hiding that they're going to do it, okay? Now get this, the bottom of the deck is also mask, another mask. So what it's saying is that you may even sit there and go, yeah, but you know, I'm sure this person's going to do it. And maybe you've asked friends or family or even them and they're like, no, this is not going to be the case. They're lying, okay? They're lying. The fact that the ring has come up twice and the mask has come up twice, either they're getting downloads to say you are, they're going to marry you. They could even be dreaming about this. I've got goosebumps right now. They could even be dreaming about this, right? Now that's one element. And you could be sat there having the same dream, asking them and them going, no, I've not had a dream. They're lying. Or for the maybe 1% of you watching, this is going to be a literal offer. It's going to be, because there's, you're both, because we've got two, we've got mirroring here. So this is possibly twin flame energy. But the fact that the lightning's come through and Cupid and achievement is like, I've got to jump into the tarot now, right? Because there's a lot going on here. Let's go with the secret tarot for some secret information coming to light. And we're going to have to name this reading the secret, the positive secret. So let's take a look. There could also be a house move here as well with the castle. Wow, this is insane. I've got goosebumps. Congratulations for whoever this is for. You need to let me know. All right. If this happens, you need to let me know, please. Okay. Aries, please. Oh my goodness, I've got goosebumps. Aries, 15th to the 31st. Aries, 15th to the 31st of December 2020. I can't. This is insane. This is the Ten of Cups. You can't make it up. This is like ultimate wish fulfillment. This is children. This is the family home. I'm hearing happily ever after. I just keep hearing wish fulfillment. This is insane. The bottom of the deck is the Seven of Pentacles. It could be a long time coming, or this could be something that, again, people, there's a very strong realization here. There's a real strong realization of what's to come. This is, again, it's a new cycle. Again, look, air. Someone, again, this could have been a friendship that's about to get deeper, all right? This is the future. Someone's dreaming of the future. Someone is dreaming of the future here. They're seeing the truth as to what, if they've tried to put this in the friend zone, good luck with that. Because this is, it's like a reoccurring energy that keeps coming up. The Four of Cups is on the bottom of the deck. They could have at one point dismissed this, but they know in the future that it's, I've got goosebumps so hard. Like I can't speak right now. There was a slow build up to this. I can't talk. This was a real slow build up. I feel like whatever energy, it feels like the 20th round, the 21st, if I'm totally honest with you. Kaboom, it's lightning. It's like, oh my goodness, I can't put this off anymore. All right. It could be that they've got an increase in confidence that's going to allow them to do this. And again, the Seven of Pentacles, again, it's like at every opportunity, you could have had two false starts with this. This could be the third opportunity to start. I've got, like, guys, I'm sorry to keep saying I've got goosebumps because this energy is insane. The bottom of the deck is the Two of Cups. You cannot make this up. You cannot. And just FYI, I'm not like just randomly picking cards. I'm actually shuffling. This is insane. Oh my goodness, I've got like all these different songs in my head. You know, like proper romantic. very magical. I'm going to be really honest with you. And I don't know why, but now I'm seeing Paris. Oh my goodness, I'm seeing Paris. This is ridiculous. This is super romantic. They don't want to be without you. They don't want to be without you. They've been thinking about this, and it's like they know if they take this too slowly, I've got a smile at this, they know that there's a risk of losing you. This is this shift is, this is a big shift. Okay, I'm recording this on the 9th of December, just FYI, which definitely there was a shift yesterday. If you hadn't felt it, there was. I was waiting for this shift. But there's definitely it's like we're in no man's land at the moment. This is, Spirit are putting this together. Literally, they're putting this together. They're clearing the way, I'm hearing. This is divinely led, guys. This is divinely led. I can't. We've got the Emperor's arrived. This is Aries energy as well. I don't know why, but can you see there's a security element here. It's like he's battle ready. That's how I want to say it. And the Sun again. So we've had the Sun twice. In charge and in control. This person's had a major boost in confidence. Again, because we've got the Castle. They can't hide this. It's like, why bother? So if you've had a gut instinct about this developing, that'll be why. We've got the Stars. So there's been a healing element here. Someone's had some time to heal. Oh my goodness. There could have been a third party energy here at one point. We've got the Three of Cups, the Queen of Pentacles, the Two of Wands, and the Queen of Cups. I'm just hearing they weren't quite ready to offer their cup before. They weren't quite ready to offer their cup before. They weren't at a certain level to offer this at one point in time. I just keep hearing this has been a long drawn out process because they've been ignoring this for so long. Again, if they'd previously offered someone else a connection or a relationship, there's a reconciliation that's being brought forward towards you, towards their person. They just needed to, there needed to be the right energy. There needed to be the right energy. Now, for some of you, this person's not going to offer this yet. But there's definitely a realization if they haven't already had it. And for some of you, there will be an offering this month. There could have been arguments, previous arguments about your expectations versus theirs. There could have been a lot of confusion around what's going to be happening with this situation. And a lot of lost opportunity possibly, or you thinking, well, this is never going to happen. Yeah, because of other people or other influences here. But this is definitely a long-term situation that's... They had a fear of coming towards this situation. So again, there's two different elements here. I've got one element that's ready to come forward and another element that's starting to realise they're going to have to, because it's not going away, but there's a fear. They're not quite ready. Let's have a look though. Let's see what's going to happen. It looks like now they are. We've got the Two of Cups and the Six of Swords. So there's definitely a brand new cycle coming in here. They want to offer it. Why are they talking themselves out of being ready. They feel like they're not ready, but because they don't have anything to offer. They feel like they don't have anything to offer. They want to maintain independence until they can balance the situation out. It's like they're building for their future. Do you know what? I keep hearing... It's like they're saving up for money for a ring or something. They want to charge in. It's like they're imagining all these things, but they're not... Let's see what they're going to do. Yeah, confusion. Lots of confusion. This could have been previous energy here. That's about to close out. Let's see what's going to happen though. 15th to 31st for Aries. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. No. Let's have a look. There's a lot of underlying emotion here that needs to balance, that they need to understand. I'm just hearing closing out of a chapter. They're in this again. Like I said, the mask and the ring. They're denying it. They're trying to put this on hold. And they just want to start a new chapter. But is it the chapter with you? Or is it the old chapter, but a renewal of the old chapter? Let's have a look. There's a... Okay, so... I feel like something is going to stop them in their tracks. They're going to try and attempt to build on to this, like, an old cycle and continue an old cycle. But something's going to stop them in their tracks here. There could be some information coming to light, or something happens in their work life or life in general that stops them in their tracks. Because we've got the Tower moment here and the Three of Swords. So let's have a look. What is this Tower moment and Three of Swords, please? There's an ending. There's an ending with the Eight of Wands. So something closes very abruptly. Let's have a look what that is. Okay, Spirit, what is this Tower moment, please? Aries, what is the Tower moment? For Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. What is the Tower? What is the Tower moment that shows between the 15th and 31st? There's something, again, third party situation possibly. Clarify Three of Cups. Wow. There's a loss. That they have a loss. There could be something, because we've got the Fool and landing on the ring with the third party. So the third party, that they could be in a third party, or they could be in a relationship where that person goes off with someone else. That could be a possibility, but there's some kind of shock. What is the Fool, the Three of Cups with the ring, please? Now, this could be okay, either you get another offer or their karmic is getting another offer, but someone is, because we've got two rings here. We've got a lot of mirroring. So there's a lot of truth and then a new cycle. Okay, so let's see what happens. And that's going to be different for absolutely everyone. So let's take a look at the outcomes here. Let's take a look at the outcomes for you guys for the 15th to 31st. I think I'm going to do outcomes differently. I think I'm going to do outcomes differently here. Let's have a look. Okay. Spirit, what is the outcome, please? 15th to 31st for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. They've realized who is their divine counterpart. They've realized it. They've come to the realization. It's from, if they didn't listen to their intuition and they were putting something off, this is about to become very obvious to them. Okay, so what's the outcome for their person? An unsuccessful victory. There's something that's, again, yeah, there's a lack of, they, whatever they were focusing on other than you, the expectation is not matching the reality, and there's a massive imbalance. Again, it could be, let's say they've gone off with someone else, that person is not reciprocating that loyalty that they would have shown. Okay, let's see what the outcome is for you though. What is the outcome for Aries? Yeah, there's some, there could be some lying or deception that they're gonna find out about. Again, either you're having to, you've got someone else around you, or their karmic has someone else around them, but they're coming into that realization. What is the outcome? Yeah, they're realizing what they've done. I think there's a realization of the cycle they've been in. I just keep hearing they're putting it to bed. There's a cycle that's being closed out here. Let's have a look at the angel answers. What is the outcome for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, please? 15th to the 31st of December 2020. We've got trust and romance. So if this doesn't quite come together at the end of the month, trust that there's a divine process in at hand here. That, again, could be that they're trying to be reflected back some truth. Again, we've got forgiveness. So there could be someone asking for forgiveness here. pay attention for that. So let's have a look. And what is the outcome, please? Sun, moon, rising, fire signs for Aries, 15th to the 31st. Aries, please. Sun, moon, rising, Venus signs. What is the outcome? 15th to the 31st of December 2020. What is the outcome? What is the outcome, please, for Aries? Keep getting Paris. I honestly keep, I'm getting France and Paris here. Could be a message from someone. Could be a trip being planned. I'm going to be honest with you. Someone could be wanting to meet you there. Maybe in January. Let's have a look. What is the outcome, please? What is the outcome for the 31st of December for our Aries? Something. We've got rest and relaxation is essential. So it could be asking you to take a break from this. If you're, we all have a fundamental need to take a break. So there could be a break coming within your connection because they're not quite ready. So remember I said at the beginning, it's like either some of you are going to be realizing this and they're going to be coming forward, or they're going to be realizing they're not ready and taking a step back and you're going to be realizing they're not ready. So we need to kind of adjust this accordingly. We've got demonstrate love in the reverse. Find out what is important to those you love and act on it. So someone is not acting on this. I think someone's going to hold back, all right? So there's something about the future that's being looked at. So again, someone could be getting some karmic lessons taught to them. So they're not quite ready. They're going to need to heal from that and come forward. But I think you may get one or two people that watch this that has someone come forward to them and with an actual commitment, all right? But the majority of you, someone is learning really where you fit in with their lives and where this is going to happen in the future. So it'll be interesting to see what happens in January for you guys. All right, so hopefully that's been of some help, Aries. Thank you so much for your likes, your shares, and your subscription. It means a lot to me. I wish you guys the best of luck, and let me know what happens for you. If this is an actual proposal or someone comes forward, do let me know. I wish you the best of luck. Until next time, take care.